at their work. We all don't agree on how we get the work done, but we all agree that work has to be done. What's happening with this Idle No More movement, to me, it is uniting all of us grassroots people. You take a look at the person standing beside you. We all come from different races, colors, creeds. We all have different, we represent different aspects of our society. That is uniting us. The Idle No More movement to me was to bring light to this crazy governance that Harper and his colleagues are doing. It's mind-boggling, and I'm so proud that it's the First Nations people who are bringing it to light. And I'm very proud that we're doing it in a peaceful way, like those aunties and those sisters, those grandmothers asked us to do. And I'm very proud that women, the first teachers in our lives, are standing up and saying, enough is enough. We're taking back our spot. We always had a position in our cultures, in our societies, and we were always a leader within our societies. We must never forget that. It is our turn now to teach the rest of the world. This is how you do governance. This is how you govern a people. What I ask from you today is whether you agree or disagree with what's happening with our Aboriginal leadership back east, is that we pray. Because work is going to happen whether we're at the table or not. We all have to pray for strength and that our leaders rely on what their mothers and their grandmothers and their aunties have taught them. All the words I have for you today have been shared. I just want to let my dear aunties know that are sitting in the front row here that I cannot stay right till the end. I have a daughter at home who's nursing my granddaughter, and they have appointments this afternoon. So I might have to, I will have to leave you here earlier, but my heart is filled with strength to see my beautiful aunties, our elders, sitting here in the front row. Aitsepka, thanking all of you.